There we are. We should be live. I'm gonna put this at around the highest or so. And let's hope that this stream will go ahead faultlessly, flawlessly, however you want to say it. But anyway, welcome back to the playthrough streams. Let's just adjust the light a tad. That's off, that's not what I want, like that. Let's just start with the Ryan Cooper only challenge. Or like, continue. We only have two cars, and by the way, I'm going to make this black. How are y'all doing today? I think this looks much better than yellow, to be honest, and it fits for a drag car. Any HTML5 games? Do you mean like Flash games or? Yesterday I also maybe it did light on the gray panels. I also want to make this a bit darker, because I am pretty sure. Yeah, and look at that, it's way darker, also more cyan-y. Like this, make it a little bit more darker, not too much. This looks much better. Almost perfect. Almost perfect. And let's make this, indeed, as you said, Magnus. Can I? Let's see if we can actually match. That's about this. Maybe one dark. How about we make it metallic? Maximus, how are you doing? No, I don't think it should be metallic and should be one darker. I think it's pretty much impossible to match. This is alright. How about we do it in like... Ooh. We're gonna have a look. I've already made the grip card dark green. I wanna make it do a different color for every single version. You know what? This looks alright. I'm gonna keep it like this. And my thoughts were to do the speed car like dark blue-ish, and then the drift car red. I'm also done with this song, by the way. Pink for speed challenge is also not a bad idea. But I feel like it should be like darkish pink. Because here's the thing, what I pretty much realized, maybe not yesterday, but in the entire span of us going to the temporary home to us moving back here, the Netgear router hasn't had like a restart. I think the song is that this stream will go ahead. How about that? Down to three-ish. Oh yeah, I'm done with it being in automatic, by the way. So like I was saying before, you're gonna be seeing some new faces out there shopping out of gameplay, assist, no mode options, grip, manual. You just have to do Pro Street in at least manual. I'd like to be in control of my gears in Pro Street. I don't think the steering is bad. I mean, tuning helps a lot. I also feel like I want to get those keyboard dampers sooner than later, given that I've resumed streaming again. And given that the metal frame on my keyboard is quite, like, hitting it is quite loud. Like, yeah, that is loud. Some keyboard dampers will actually do us quite nicely. I've actually owned Pro Street, well, not owned, I had Pro Street on the Wii, but, you know, I've never really played it for, like, a very long time, given that I have no PC as well. This song is very quiet. No point shifting into fifth. Pretty much no point. Yesterday I did a private stream test for about 45 minutes and it didn't drop frames. Pretty much what I did is just restarted our Netgear router, because like I said, from in the span of us moving to the temporary home to moving back, it didn't have a restart. We just disconnected it, it reconnected it, but it never had a proper reboot. Maybe all it needed was just a kick in the butt and then it was all good again. So far so good. How is the sound balance, you know, me, the music, the game volume? Is there something, is something too loud? Is something not loud enough? I mean, obviously the music is now a bit on the low end, but if I do the next song. Or maybe it was just that, like, the previous song was just a tad loud. I've been using keyboards for racing games ever since I played racing games. My first racing game was pretty, like, the first racing game that I've played for a very long time was Underground. And I've played it since pretty much it came out. So I was like 5 years old back then. So that's 20 years old. It's 20 years that I've been playing with keyboard and mouse for racing games. All famous X-testing track. This is so narrow, by the way. Why did I ever choose this as a testing track? It's so bad. It's so much worse than Autopolis. To fifth at the last possible moment. Thing is though, I don't have a good steering wheel at the moment, and a good one can cost you so much money. So yeah. And I always feel like whenever I get a racing wheel, it'll spend more time collecting dust than actually being used. Yeah, basically, he's been using a keyboard and mouse also for a very long time for racing game. Same like me, so he's just used to it. Are we steering wheels isn't that expensive? I don't think so. Look at that, almost 30 seconds in front. That's insane. Early game will not be a challenge. For sure. At all. What should you make your profile picture? I don't know. Let's have a look how good the S14 is as right now for drag racing. I don't want to upgrade this car too soon, basically. So basically I want to keep it sort of challenge. So I'm not going to upgrade the grip to 40SX anytime soon. I'm just glad that stage 3 drag to 40SX is actually quite good. Also for wheeling, it's also very good. I mean, it's good for now, but I think that's even worse than the Cobalt. It'll do for now, but I might give it a force induction. And the gearbox is definitely not long enough for a half mile. So we also need a gearbox tune and upgrade. Last night I was getting frustrated because I was having a hard time finding out why it wouldn't let me shift. Turns out it's because clutch was on and I don't use clutch. Ah. You definitely do want to use clutch for drag racing though. That will give you a massive boost, a massive advantage. Evie, what the hell is that? Good start. Best time so far. Just a bit underwhelming, but you know. It's decent for... I hate it when you only need a very little amount of points. Two time attacks. Let's do this. No, let's do this one. It's a good look into 40SX. I didn't remove the speed limit during testing. All the cars have the vanilla speed limit. But this version of Pro Street that I'm doing right now doesn't have a speed limit. Because I don't like the speed limit. Good overtake. On the outside. That's a good overtake. Wide here, then on the inside here. Staying in fourth, that's a good one. That's a good lap, even though it wasn't our fast lap. Look at that, we're so much faster than the rest. Ah, that's unfortunate. Need to pay attention. Okay, this is not going to be a fast lap. I would say clutch is only like necessary in drag racing. Otherwise, for other modes, it isn't really necessary. I only use clutch for drag racing, so mainly because you just simply need it for that game mode. Okay, now time for a fast lap. Bit wide. Not bad. Come on! Ooh, I think that was a sub 1 minute. Yes, it was! Lovely! Yes! Oh! It crashed. Occasionally, yeah, I do drive in real life. I hope it's saved. I don't want to do that again. You're joking. It didn't save. Well, I'm gonna do it again. Awful lot of crashing though, I have to say. I mean, with a car that my parents own, you do want to drive as many times as possible. I don't own a car personally, because simply I don't need a car yet. And B, I don't really have too much money to spend on a car. And I don't want to buy like a crappy, terrible car. I might understeer a bit, but they understeer massively, which is to be expected. was a good corner. That was a good... Why is it always that our first laps are great? They're terrible. Okay, again, our third lap is going to be our fast lap. Occasionally a route, but only at like good steak restaurants. I've looked a bit into like first cars. Basically, I first want to get myself a proper job, so I can have a proper income, and then I can look at what my budget is for a first car. Keep it in the lines, there we go. A bit wide, but nothing major. Keep it in third here. Fourth and Nossett. Go wide here, look for the apex, there, slow down a bit, there we go, lovely, can we get another sub 1 minute? That was better, what was it, a 59.56, lovely, don't crash please, lovely, okay, what did I miss? The stream is... like I said, I think just a simple reboot of the router just fixed it. Okay, one thing that I definitely have to do... is... that was quite neat actually, Cyber, too, for that... steering wheel trick. Drivetrain. We need at least a stage 1 drivetrain. And I'd like to have... Oh, we already have a stage 1 force reduction. Engine is going to be quite expensive for now. Yeah, that's then half our money gone. And basically, we need more power. So I'm gonna... better NOS. It's again 10 grand. I'm gonna wait and see how the drivetrain will handle 4/4 mile. I'm happy as is with the grip car. Actually, this is already a great show to just test what a great drivetrain tune would be. First gear is just definitely too low. That's already a thing I can tell. It also makes doing burnouts a bit difficult. I mean, the gear ratio itself is pretty good. The power is there. So, what if we just... do this. And yeah, that's literally it. Favorite country? I mean, probably the country I live in right now, so the Netherlands. I don't really have a favorite country, to be honest. Yeah, burnouts are difficult in this thing. Yeah, I think it's pretty much perfect with the power that we have right now. True Magnus, true Magnus. Let's do a race for the 240SX. The grip is there, you know, it doesn't wheel spin off the launch. Ever so slightly. Basically, if we install another power mod, we need stage 2 gearbox. We just need it then. $18.36. That's miles better than the second place. So we are good for now. But it's just a tad slow. Oh, we got a subscriber, Bob the Builder, nice. What a name. Bob the Builder. I don't know what the theme song is in English. But speaking of emulator, I am thinking about doing an undercover playthrough on like the PS2/Wii era. And also what's been suggesting is Pro Street on the DS, but I have to look into that. But I'm definitely curious about the undercover for PS2 and Wii playthrough. Might get like a P... Was it PS... Nay, PC... Something. X2. What if I nos later? On 5th maybe, I don't know. I don't think it made too much of a difference. No, it's a bit slower even. Hey, 9,000 points, I'll take it. Well, it does flame because it's pretty much the most wanted / carbon handling. It's pretty much the same. It's basically like a remix, not even a remaster, but a remix of Most Wanted. That's pretty much what it is. Same with the map. That's literally a remix of the Most Wanted map. God, this is slow. That Civic is pretty much just buggering off, isn't he? Obviously, speed streaming is helping. He's braking a lot. And get him on the outside. Lovely. That is unfortunate, Flame, but we can have our own music playlist like I'm having right now. I mean, 9,000 miles is in this playthrough, of is in this playlist. This is basically like a music playlist of most Need for Speed songs, including Drive Pro Line songs, GTA 4, the Battle of Gaytoni songs, some Killing Floor songs, and some Wreckfest songs. So, oh Jesus, that scared me. Jumpscare Golf. There's no way I can keep up with him, though. Yeah, he's just buggering off. But he's in... he's a B-racer, so... And then there's another one coming. Boom. Cheeky split stream. This is all it has. I'm definitely better in the corners though. I mean, the only thing that golf is somewhat good at is speed races, and even there, it's average at best. There's the Challenger. Nintendo Entertainment System. Well, I didn't grow up with that era of gaming, so I don't know. Not much. Perhaps play some games in it occasionally, but... Tobias, I think that's a new name. 182, that's all it has. 182 kilometers an hour, and there is the C2 coming. I'm defending a bit. Oh, Gavin May going wide, but it doesn't matter too much. Keeping it within the lines, lovely. And we just keep it in fourth. There we go, that's not bad. I'm expecting that Corvette to overtake me any time on this straight. I can defend all I want, but he's just blasting by. There we go. Cheeky little split stream. Oop, I think it can happen. There we go. A bit wide, understeer, yeah. The guy in fourth is just a joke, isn't he? Alex Hutton. Yes, I need coffee to function, Groot. Again? Wow. It crashes a lot. Is there something I can do about it? I think I can do too much about it, to be honest. I don't think there's much that I can do here. Everything has been enabled. It crashes a lot though. I mean, if it crashes like every other race. I mean, that's bad. Let's just hope it's safe. I mean, last time it didn't. I don't care about Markiplier, to be honest. I don't have a lot with big YouTubers, like massive YouTubers. I do occasionally look back on chat after I've done a race, but repeating the message like 1 minute after you've said the original one, that doesn't really help too much. I mean, Ryan Cooper and the stick are pretty much the same, so I don't know. Good song this. I've been using this song quite a lot in my videos. with a cheeky off-roading. That's a bit wide. That's very wide. Well, not really rude because he wouldn't talk at all. Is it a defense? No, I don't have a defense. A nighttime Pro Street, that would be quite cool, but not on a track like this because you would need external lights. Basically like a night race. That would be cool though. I could try the non-speed limit version. See, that crashes less. This route, this is what I'm doing tonight. He's not going past, is he? He's just right behind me. There's a whole lot of room on my right, and he is not taking it. Wow, what a bad racer. I thought I'm going to defend a little bit on the inside or the middle. Ooh! Ooh! We nearly died. Suspension is still a bit stiff. S13 is hella light. And I have it with stiff suspension on the rear. See which one I can still have. All of them! There we go! Come on! Not towards the line though. Come on, power! You're allowed to do one move on the straight. That's what I did. What if it's the autosave feature though? Maybe that's... I don't know. How much do we need to actually like dominate? Oh, I've already done everything. Willow Springs? Yeah, that's a Willow Springs. Fortunately, did have some weird song, I have to say. Practical. I'm just gonna go pop practice. Oh, Michael Harris! I've changed my name to my game attack, so. Practical. I'm probably just gonna still call you Michael, by the way. Let's do the oval, the regular GP race. Next song. Nice! Before the first turn. P8 to P1. Lovely. Peanut butter. Not a very much a fan of peanut butter. It is so slow though, this car. Like, really not powerful at all. That is going to be like an issue for like later grip events. Because I do plan to... every single challenge playthrough I do on Pro Street, I want to get Street King. So I want to beat every single King. And I think that Grip King against, you know, Rudy Chen, those guys, that will be difficult. Again, for the Battle Machine era, we have no difficulties whatsoever. It's just a bit boring, to be honest, especially on a track like this. OSCs? I don't know what that is. OSCs? Or OCs? Original characters. Do I have any original characters? I have no idea what you mean with that I have original. Like figures or... Something about roleplay? I genuinely don't know. Not much of a minifigure collector, if that's what you mean. The only thing that I kind of collect are like tiny model cars, but I'm sure many of us do. No, then I don't. Then I don't. Now this track, this is a track that the 2-foot is actually going to be much better at. Even though we just dominated the opponents. You know, Corolla 240SX and then Group B has a 768 brake horsepower Chevelle. That's empty. But I still have another bottle. Bloody hell. My car! I would say that maybe the clutch in like grip races can be a bit of a challenge if you're not used to it. But for drag races it isn't too much of an issue. I didn't actively collect Hot Wheels. Like I said, I was just like a regular model car collector. A good line. Still between the white lines. And that's way too wide. Let's slow it down a bit. Just do a late exit. Let's just pretend I just did a late exit. Let's just go over through them. I think for both grip and drag, I would say the Subaru Impreza. or speed. The Subaru Impreza is basically the only decent, only good all-wheel drive car for grip racing, and for speed races, yeah, probably the Evo 10. Or no, wait, for speed race the 911 Turbo. Skyline. Yeah. It's surprisingly bad for drag races. It's alright for speed races, and I would say pretty good for grip races. But the Subaru and the Evo 10 are better. And the Skyline in for grip races has bad brakes. That's something I've remembered quite fondly. It has bad brakes for grip races. A bit wide here, but yeah, that's okay. That's a great line. That was an amazing line. Probably Roots. Again, wow. That's just way too often. I'm gonna try the original version. See if that crashes less. Or what if I... What if I... Because I remember... Just changing the name of the executable file. And that obviously increases the volume. I'm gonna do that back to 10. And if this doesn't help, it's very likely the autosave feature indeed. But then I need to remember to autosave. Was that game crashing in the stream on Tuesday? I don't remember that actually. I don't think it was. Also empty. Last bottle. I drink a lot. I currently have something stuck in my throat and it doesn't go away, so that's why I drink a lot right now. Well, at least it's water, so. Well, technically not. I'm currently doing an internship. So, I don't go to school, but I go to the internship via school, if that makes sense. AI is breaking literally everywhere. I'm trying to do a switcheroo, but it's not happening. Oh, outside. Well, he crashed. It's obvious the Civic is faster on the straight. Yeah, you braked over there. Bloody hell. Get out of the way! We go around him in a slow corner. He's understeering quite heavily. On the outside here. For sure, for sure. On the outside. There we go. No, it's not happening. Even with an ugly, then he's doing those. Why are you braking there? There we go. Bit wise. This is not an intervention or something, you know, it isn't. No, I'm not really into the modding scene. What I've occasionally done is like edit car sounds and change car behavior, like power and gearbox thingies, but not stuff with AI. White lines, there we go. Ah, a bit white. Junith, the menu theme. It's not really a menu theme. I'm racing now, I'm not changing the car, so I'm just gonna skip the song for now. Maybe introduce it when we're changing the car.
So like I was saying before, you're gonna be seeing some new faces out there chopping it up with the usual suspects here at Battle Machine. They're rookies though. These are just some of their first races where they don't have
to... Oh, like I just made the 15,000 mark.
So watch out for them today.
Yes, that is true. If you don't want the understeer, I mean, you're just much better off playing Most Wanted. Marker 5, okay. Then we go for Marker 5. Then we have the biggest joke of Need for Speed Pro Street, the guy in front of me. How did Rio actually hire him? I mean, he's in the Battle Machine era. It's pretty much, yeah, he's a joke. I mean, yeah, we're not using slicks, that's for sure. I mean, I'd assume that it has to be legal cars, and slicks are obviously illegal. Ah, damn it. Yeah, but... Here's the thing, Magnus. When I think of Battle Machine, I think of like rookies, you know? Why send an experienced guy over to rookies? Just let the rookies race. Or maybe perhaps Joe Taggart is a rookie, but why would... Did I crash into something? Why would Rio hire a rookie? The best handling car is either the Mazda RX-8 or the Citroën Coupe. Well, actually, I mean the 240SX is one of the better handling cars in the game, along with the RX-8 and, well, obviously the McLaren F1, but that's a whole different galaxy. But yeah, the Mazda RX-8 is overall probably the easiest car to handle with a good central speed. But I also like the 240SX handling and the Citadel Cupra handling. Also, the Lancia Delta isn't bad either. That's a great line. Could be a thing though, actually, that that Rio actually hired Joe Tacker just to stop Ryan Cooper from progressing. But then why would he give Joe Tackett a crumpy old Honda Civic? Why not, like, I don't know, what's... Obviously it has to be Japanese cars, because all of Rio's crew uses a Japanese car. Why not, like, I don't know, what's a semi-grip... Infiniti G35, maybe? I don't know. It just doesn't make sense.
Oh, hey, check it out. Watch out for Yoshi Suzuki out there. The guy's the point man for the Toge Union team. Here, Yoshi's...
Let's open this bottle. And let's tear off. Oh, it didn't have... I hated that these plastic bottles usually come with... This one comes with like a thingy that you have to keep the cap on. I hate it, but this doesn't actually.
Good stuff.
I rarely actually drink Dr. Pepper. Sprite is also not bad. $11.53, that's not bad. Is there a good starter car for drag, speed and drifting? Yeah, the RX-8. The RX-8 is a car that you can buy in me. I'm pretty sure it is. And it's great for everything. Except for wheeling. It's not great for wheeling, but... It's great for, it's amazing for grip, it's great for drag, it's good for speed, and it's amazing for drift. I would also say that the RX is just the best car overall for everything. If you want to do the one and done challenge where you can only use one car for the entirety of the run, the RX-8 is definitely your best bet. Yeah, but the stage 4 ranking will have to wait for a little bit. I haven't started with the wheelie ranking. Well, ranking is just a tier list. Then speed, then drift, and then I will have to start testing the grip cars, then editing it, do the voiceover, and testing will take a little bit of time, given that I have an internship. But yeah, it'll happen eventually, just don't know when. Don't crash, don't crash, don't crash. Alright, marker 5. I'm hoping something engine-wise. Meh. Bit underwhelming. I would immediately pass it to someone else, because I am not much of a leader. I could just do it on random, you know? Just close my eyes and blah blah blah. I wish I could skip this, by the way. We're already at 2,500 views for the drag video? Wow, that's insane. How much does the grip video has? 3,500. So it's just literally 1,000 views away from overtaking the grip video. And it's only been up for a day. That's insane. Holy moly. How is he revving his car, by the way, if he's standing on the door? That is something I've always questioned.
Alright, Rio, thanks for doing this. Come on, it sounds like you're gonna be driving out.
Would appreciate it, Magnus. But don't comment just to comment. But you know, like all that stuff. If likes already help a lot. Whoa. That was a good overtake. On the outside, there we go, lovely. Oh, that was perfect. Those were two perfect corners. Trying to get close to the wall. But then that'll happen. Still in the race though, no heavy damage whatsoever. Not that it matters in vanilla. I think I can do that corner that is coming up ahead flat out. I'm gonna do it flat out. Yeah, easy flat out. Easy flat out. Not if there's a car in the way. Shift to fourth and that was decent, not too bad. That route. I would not say that. I don't think you can beat this game with any car. Wouldn't be a fun way to like experiment to find out like with how bad of a car you can beat the Kings. Like starting out in like the Charger for grip, the Focus for drag, the RSX for speed, and then the Shelby for drift. just seeing how far you can get with those cars, and if you are losing, just move up a tier of cars. That would be an interesting playthrough, like trying to beat the game with the worst possible cars. Again. But I would not touch the Civic at all. God damn it, Joe! Why did I sound American all of a sudden? God damn it, Joe! Get out of my way, boy! I would think so, Magnus, because the Focus is a 10-second car. Like, you would at best make it through some reacting sessions events. But, like, I know for certain that, like, Carol Monroe can, like, run 6.5-second races. So you would need a car that is at least as good as that. I'm pretty sure it's like 6.5-ish, so just having a look. If it actually loads. Load! Yes, I am Dutch. No, it didn't crash, it just alt-topped. I am using 144Hz monitor. Load! Excel, trying to access the printer. Why do you need the printer? Just want to show... Let's have a look. It now currently ranks for drag. I know that you can... 7.5-second-ish. That's like... This top 50 can maybe do it for drag racing. But like the Focus, 10 seconds, no way. No way. Like, here's the thing, like, this is a tier, like these two are a tier, and then the Civic will be the next tier. Then probably the Integra, I don't know. Or grip. Yeah. I know I've beaten Rio once in a C2 Corvette. That was pretty difficult. So again, you're probably looking at top 50. Speed challenges are quite easy. But it's difficult to say what car you need to actually beat the Speed King. No, Root, the Scirocco doesn't beat GT2. Alright, let's close this for now. It hasn't crashed so far, by the way. So. This is it. We got our first round ready to go here. Just because the C2 is bad, you gave up playing undercover? Wow. I mean, I love the C2 Corvette, but I mean, there are plenty of other cars to use. The Chevelle or the Challenger are also great tier 3 cars in undercover. I used to go for the Challenger for my tier 3 car. I wonder if this car is good enough for this event. It is, wow. Yeah, we have established that you can beat undercover. Well, maybe not the the checkpoint races, but you can pretty much beat the regular races with a stock Golf, so like any car. Cyberball, then I would recommend you trying the reformed mod, because that changes literally every car's handling. It just makes Undercover so much better, and I would probably never play Undercover Vanilla anymore. Just have the reformed mod, because that's literally just a direct upgrade. I just have no feelings for the Nissan Sentra. I just don't care for it. It's just some car for me, you know? Just a couple of feet of some metal and rubber. That's all that the Nissan Sentra is to me. I just don't care for it. I have the reformed mods in my Discord server. If you look up the Undercover section on the game downloads, you will find the reformed mod under there. Oh, it crashed again. Okay, so that did not help at all. Meaning that we are going to... But why is it doing that though? Maybe I need to... Because I have some other stuff in my save file. Like all of this stuff. What if I just, you know... I'm not gonna delete it, but... Pro Street save stuff. Maybe it's interfering with that? I have no idea, to be honest. If this doesn't help, I'm gonna have to disable autosave. No. The visuals have changed. Oh, fuck, now I'm gonna have to... Okay. Leave anyway. This. But I haven't changed the save file. So why is it doing this? Because this isn't saved. Okay. What is all this, by the way? Could it be something inside your CD key? Could it be because of this? I don't have a CD key? Could it be because of that? I have a CD key in my Discord server. So I'm just gonna quickly go over there. I can't see chat now right now, by the way. Pro Streets. Game downloads. Then, right, boom. Could it be because of that? Probably isn't. And I also have... Look at all this. What if I just copy-paste this? I think that will do too much, but we'll just wait and see if that actually fixes something. No speed limit. What did I miss? The worst grip car in Underground is the Supra. All good now. But yeah, we would have to do this again. CD, putting a CD key in the INI file saves all the settings. Well, I mean, it should save all the settings. Maybe it was interfering with that. I would think that the Supra isn't bad, it's just a frustratingly understeery car. Definitely for drift races though, I would just not... I mean, I would refuse to do the drift event in any other car besides the MX-5, Subaru Impreza, or the S2000. Because drifting needs to be fun in Underground, I don't want it to be frustrating. Orf, that's also a good idea, Mark. Is that that super unfinished trucking game route? Because then I would have no desire to play it. I mean, I don't mind bad cars as long as they're fun. So a great example in this game is the Camaro, the classic Camaro. It's slow, it oversteers terribly, but it's a fun car to use. Same like the Seat Leon Cupra, same like the 240SX. The 240SX is not an amazing car for grip racing. It's like somewhere in the top 30 or something-ish, but it just handles so good that it makes it so much fun to use. Did I crash into something? Can someone clip that? Did I crash into nothing? I don't know. Then no, we'll have to wait and see. I cannot really plan streams much earlier than like 2 days in advance, you know? I mean... I have the time to stream this week mainly because my girlfriend had like an operation and she's like basically knocked out for now. Usually by these times I would just go and spend time with my girlfriend, but you know, she's a lot sleepy, so I'm just gonna let her rest for like at least 2 weeks. So maybe next week I also have plenty of time to stream, but we'll see after that. So it just was a coincidental that, you know, I started streaming again this week because I had the time. This is a slow and bit of a boring song, so I'm just gonna skip this one. Play Animal Jam, I have no idea what kind of game that is. I feel bad for the charge. Have you ever played Lose the Heat 3? Lose the Heat 3. No, I have never heard of that game at all. Shift to 4th mark. That's a good idea on the twisty roads.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Oh, OBS isn't on. Otherwise, I can't see what is happening right now with OBS. Still no dropped frames, so yeah, just restarting the router has fixed it. Bit weird though, but it is what it is. Also, I don't have to go to internship tomorrow, so I can stream a little bit later than 10 p.m. We'll just wait and see. Mayonnaise. Yes, I guess. Is it an instrument? Terrible car. Terrible car. Decent at best. I know I did. Yeah, I guess then Magnus, because I didn't see anything to crash into. Ooh. Hey, Tomato, how you doing, mate? On the inside, there we go, lovely. Then go there. Oh, that was a great corner. That's okay, Tomato, glad you're here. Eat shit, Joe Taggart, on the outside. I don't care that I missed a score, I'm just glad I can overtake Joe Taggart on the outside. I love this engine sound, it's amazing. Light damage, damn it. Nice! That was decent. Yeah, I guess you've heard this engine sound more than many. As you've customized it heavily, didn't you? Joe Taggart. He's literally my arch enemy. Yeah, I wanted a different color for every mode, and I did black first, then I wanted gray because that fits with the body panels. Ooh, actually, can you do that, Tomato? But every single car, every single AI has an S13. We'll be like the Mazda MX-5 racing series, where like everyone has the Mazda MX-5. But in this case, it will be the S13 series. Because that would be a fun playthrough. Like literally the S13, well, how would you call it then? Because this is an S13 only play challenge. Like the Ryan Cooper only challenge, and like, or like the S13 World Championship? S13 Championship playthrough? I don't know. I don't really work out, to be honest. The internship that I follow pretty much allows me to walk immensely. I usually reach 10,000 steps every single day because of my internship. I've done 12,500 today. And I was sitting pretty much the entire morning. Like, let's have a look. Yeah, crazy. Oh, it crashed again. Okay. Autosave is going to get disabled because this is insane. It crashes like every third race or something. This is like genuinely insane. Goodbye, autosave. It's probably the first time I've actually disabled autosave. Well, at least it's giving me a prompt to save. So, that's a good thing. Yeah, but that would be something, wouldn't it? I wouldn't. That means I would have to restart this whole save again. I wouldn't want to do that. But I have no idea what else it could be, why it's crashing so many times. Because I've never had it crash like every third race or so. Or fourth race or fifth race, I don't know. But it crashes a lot. I've actually never been in an airplane, believe it or not. So I wouldn't know. Yeah, what I can do then is just move the save file over somewhere and then also remove the alias and just start a brand new alias, do a couple of races and see what happens, I guess. I mean, we haven't progressed that far, so if it crashes again, I will try that. Maybe I can create a different alias and then move this save file over to that alias? I don't know. Seats are very comfy and the windows have blue tints for a feature for sleeping through the... Oh, okay. Would you go to India or Singapore? I don't really have anything with those two countries, to be honest, so neither, probably. India would just be insanely busy. I don't like busy crowds. Singapore? Yeah. I don't know. No way to make it. Is it that expensive for you? And then is that just a flight or like a flight and a hotel? How expensive would it be to go from Eelde to US actually? I wonder. Or like perhaps Schiphol. I don't know where you live, Magnus, but I live in the north, so Eelde would be more preferable. Break him. No, he's squeezing. Oh. Damn it. Living right next to me. could be an American station. You actually live very close to where I live. Neon Samurai Bonsai. You're playing Pro Street right now. Oh, well. On the PC? Because I'm actually, like, toying with the idea. Well, I've been toying with it for a very long time. To, like, play online on for Pro Street. But you guys would have to need to have the exact same version of Pro Street that I have. You live in Friesland? Well, I live in Groningen, so yeah. I don't care about my time, I just want to overtake Joe Taggart on the outside. Ah, damn it. Switcheroo! No, on the outside. There we go, on the outside again. I get wrecked, mate. There we go, not too bad. Yeah, yeah. Shut up, Rio. Thumbnail there. Crashed again. You're joking. Okay. Yeah, I guess. Do a couple of races and see what's what. It's unfortunate. Get that Imperial unit out of my way. Manual. Manual. Clutch on. Speed challenge. Manual. Assist. That's alright. Controls. You know, this is all decent for now. Clutch space. What the hell? Handbrake space. Then I'll fix all that later. So I'm gonna do a couple of races. Again, I'm gonna just do 240SX. So we'll see if it crashes now. Because if it crashes again, I might have to reinstall Pro Street. Would be the biggest issue though, but I mean, we didn't progress that far. Like, I'm streaming for like an hour and a half or something. That's not too bad. Oh yeah, that's also going to go away. I've been planning to like stream for interface. That, there we are. Best line off. Tourniquets off. I mean, I even plan to stream to maybe like 11 p.m. or something, so that's another 2 hours or so. It's not the worst thing if I have to go all over again. Oh yeah, yeah, I mean, I can actually. I could do that. It's actually not a bad idea. Dragon Ball. No, I'm not really an anime watcher. You're gonna have to test if it stays stable for now. If it is actually the save file. If I can do, say, 2 race weekends without crashing, I'm gonna blame it on a save file. If I can't, I'm gonna reinstall Pro Street. And if that doesn't help, well, I don't know what will help. I mean, it's just an excuse to do more Pro Street, so. Oh, damn it. Yep, for sure. Nah, I don't want to delay it any further. Yeah, so far I don't remember it crashing this frequent. And I did start a new alias beforehand, so it could be just an alias issue. Drag terms are all about posting the fastest time. Terms can join. We're gonna scorch the strip here in round one. Both drivers got a case of left foot. We are in for quite a show. Get ready to let them hear it. But I pretty much started a new alias to fix the DLC car pricing. And that has been fixed with the new alias. I don't want my old alias to return, because that has the all the DLC cars to be free. Damn it! I usually can do the Battle Machine race weekend with just the 2 drag races. I do want to improve my time. I guess I'm just that competitive. That's good. That's good. What if I now start from without revving? Let's see if that actually is the best. Okay, all right. This is it. This is why they come out. Do not get out of those seats. If you like what you see, I want to hear about it. Get ready to fix it. Also, one thing that I want to do a bit more often is I don't know how many of you actually still play Forza Horizon 5, but perhaps some Horizon 5 online stuff. No, that's worse. So 11:41. That is 9637. So like I was saying before, you're gonna be seeing some new faces out there chopping up with the usual stuff. So that is doable. They're rookies though. These are just some. Yeah, I mean, single player wise it is, but multiplayer on Forza Horizon 5 is a lot of fun in my opinion. We'll see. There are many streams ahead in the future, so we can always do it on a later stream. Or perhaps with Forza Horizon 6 whenever that comes out. Troller, what's a troller? Like, would it be the tram in our country? Because I don't think we actually have that in the north. Ooh, 11:30, that's good enough. I can do false starts. The trolley. But would that be the tram in Dutch? Or is that a different thing? Well then, yes, pretty much every time. Like shopping carts, but... Hasn't crashed so far. No way. Oh my god. Okay. Yeah. Well, Pro Street. Is it this one I use? I don't know, to be honest. What was this one that I used? Oh, don't tell me the mod doesn't exist anymore. I would then probably have to. Okay, it still exists. Oh, it's yeah, okay. And then also another mod that I used. Pro Street HUD mod. Probably this one, I guess. Yeah, it's definitely been this one. So that's binary, I think. Yeah, it's binary. Okay, let's have a look. Gone. Let's just completely reinstall. Okay. I mean, we at least have fast internet, so it doesn't take too much. My recommendation for those types of games is either Skid Row Reloaded or IGG games. Those are the two best sites from what I've experienced. Oh, you still play Forza Horizon once a week? Yeah, that's true. Launch control and anti-lag, it is actually quite fun to use. How about we actually do now? And then I can also like completely remove these, actually not for the global 10k, if I ever want to do the 10k mod again, and then I guess I can just remove all these. Yeah. Boom. Yeah, that's almost 100 gigs of 7 different Pro Street games. And obviously, don't forget the generic fix. You are going in Pro Street, and you are also in there. One original, two no speed. Limits. I'll do those two for now. Yeah, 7 different Pro Streets equal 100 gigs. I mean, something that you that also is quite worrying. My Need for Speed testing video file. How much do you guess it is? It's a good thing I have a large HDD. 252 gigs. All of those videos, every single video is still in here. 250 gigs, and it's still counting because the stage 4 cars are also going to be tested. Holy moly. Mount ISO. Set up. English. No, not Deutsch. English. Thank you very much. Next. There we go. Next. Yes. Thank you very much. That's not needed. Right. Yeah, I was used to the Windows 10 sound scheme, so I literally copied all the Windows 10 sounds over to Windows 11. I think the Windows 10 sounds are just a bit better. This is also something I just don't get. I just got a comment. What is the song name at this? I mean, oh, they don't know. It's the blah blah blah. It's when did the song start? I don't know when the song started. Thank you. in the infographic at 15:14. This is actually taking quite a while. I mean, using wise, I don't see like pretty much any difference between Windows 10 and 11. I mean, it just looks a bit different. Oh, I was waiting for that one. I mean, in the beginning, it had some stability issues, sure, but it wasn't. It's not bad right now, definitely. This is actually taking quite a while. Cheers, guys. Yeah. By the way, if you want a sneak preview on what are the best cars in Pro Street for wheeling and for speed races. Oh yeah, trying to access the printer. Come on, come on. There we go. Basically, I mean, there are loads of S tier cars for wheeling. Like, these cars from 18 and onwards are all perfect for wheeling. These are decent, and all the A class cars are good as well. So literally all of these cars are good for wheeling, are great for wheeling. All of these cars. And then we only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 cars that are just, yeah, not great for wheeling. And the rest are amazing. So it's a bit of a hassle. And I didn't bother to rank them from worst to best because, yeah, they're pretty much all the same. Speed-wise, yeah. I mean, I'm just glad the Mazda 3 isn't in the top 10. The Mazda 3 is in the top 10 of the best speed cars. I really love that. And then drifting wise, I mean, did you expect that? Did you expect this? Did you expect this? RX-7 isn't the best drift car in Pro Street. It's not even seconds. Ah, it's done. We need to install this? I don't know, to be honest. Gonna do it anyway. No. Okay. It is installed. Now I just need to install the two mods. Let's go open. Blah, 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 blah. D. Program files. Where are you? Need for Speed modding. There you are. Binary. Open binary. There we go. In user modes. Then I'm going to down. No, I need to. Don't need to go there. I need to go to. And do need to go in downloads? Yes. No. Where the hell did I save that? Oh, I need to extract it. Ah. There we go. HUD install in games, classic games, Need for Speed, Pro Street, original. Okay. Lovely. Save files. Yes. Don't run the game because you also need to be installed for you. This Pro Street, no speed limit. Oh, the fact the game itself hasn't been installed over there, but what we can do for that? Need for speed, Pro Street, original. It has been installed in here. So I was just gonna copy it, that's much faster, and then just open this. It will be, yeah. But the Mustang 03, it was such an amazing car for drifting. So controllable, but still so much wheel spin, but so much control. It's weird because those two shouldn't go hand in hand. I'm not really a salad person in general. So you make me much happier with like bread or soups or stuff like that, but no salads. I also mustn't forget, because I did forgot that. Finish. There we go. Here's the generic fix. Put you in you. Scripts, generic fix. All right. I do need to change you to one. I think it's all right. Yes. Then you to you. There we go. Then for one final thing, I need to open. I think it was VLT. Yes, it was. Where are you? Where are you? This PC L games. Classic games. Need for Speed. Pro Street. No speed limit. Yes, there we go. Then I need to get to downloads. Speed limit removal. Then boom. Then I think I just copy this in here and then save it. I think that's all I need to do. Because it's not a mod file that I'm importing. Then, instead of using our alias that we just created, I'm going to go back to this alias. NFS Pro Street. Just remove these for now and save these. All of this has been saved, so it should automatically go back to that. Then I think we just open Pro Street then. No speed limits. It will be loud, so also no. Oh wow, what the hell? It's not a 1440p? It isn't. Okay. Oh, V-Sync. By the way, I can't see chat right now. Okay, this is... Damn it, which one was options? This is... why is it not in full screen? Do I need to like install like a widescreen patch? Is it not included in this version? Apparently it isn't. But why? Oh, this is a race day, I guess. Or this is online. This is online. I need to find the options. I don't know which one is options, bro. Ah, pick the exact same one, bloody hell. But why is it in this different weird language? Whatever these signs are. Which one is options? I think this one is options. Okay, this is not how it should be, obviously. Can I just... Also, why is this so big? Okay. Can I force it in? The right settings to and now this has been enabled. So why aren't you playing ball? This should be all right. What if I start the original one? Not... Don't know if that's actually going to make any difference. No, it's still going into a different resolution. Okay, I need to enable VSync. Why is it doing all this? This is definitely options. No, it isn't options. This is audio, I think. Yeah, but how is, why is it in such weird... Okay, oh, you hate this song? What I can do for now... Is add Pro Street through here, and yeah, but that still doesn't fix the text. Come on, this always takes such a long time. This is really taking a long time. Just generic fix, that's the only one you actually need. These things matter, to be honest. Have a look. You want max sync enabled. Oh, perhaps. It's a bit of a shame that actually we also, we again, didn't really start. Oh, both of them are? Oh, okay. Yep. Again, we didn't start with the two. Well, we did start it. but it's not going as planned. Why are you going? At least it's on 60 FPS, so it's not as slow anymore. But why is the text all wacky? I have no explanation for that at all. I mean, generic fix, does it come with a widescreen patch? Yes, it does. Let's go to the Pro Street online server. What if I, the only thing I can think of is just completely clear this for now. That's a different one. And just copy this section for now. And just start up a new one. I don't know if that will fix it. Completely new save. Shouldn't. Why is it doing this? This doesn't matter anyway. Let's just have a look. Let's just go online, see what Pro Street menu. But I don't think this is actually a common problem. Why don't we just get a multifix? Ah, sound. Oh, doesn't exist anymore. Lovely. Is it because of the A2D mod that I've actually done? See if we. No, you can't uninstall it, obviously. Nissan Speeds, Pro Speeds. Reinstall it? I don't know, to be honest. Obviously, it would say error. Because it's already installed. Menu text bug. Archive post, obviously. But he does have the exact same. Oh, it doesn't have. Generic fix, yes. No. Not a known issue that the menu is all bugged out. What if I, for now, uninstall it and reinstall it without the HUD mod? Yeah, but here's the thing, this is a preset Pro Street where that includes a couple of different things. I don't think the version should matter. It shouldn't. So appreciate what you did, Cyber, but I don't think that's going to be needed. What if I just run it without any mods beforehand? Yours came with the generic picks. Well, I have the generic picks separately. Obviously, I need to install it. But I only should need to install the Netflix. That's the only thing that I should need to do. Now we wait again. How about in the meantime we put on a good song? Any suggestions for any Need for Speed related songs or? These are all Porsche Elite songs. Underground songs, One Good Reason, or Once. Maybe there is an FAQ for... Games I need some fixes. Nerf fixes in here. It's the reflections, it's the user interface. That's literally the one that I've used. How about we wait with that one for now? Just start Pro Street Vanilla with the generic fix. Because obviously I did mess with the HUD, and the HUD was, you know, fucked up. But also the generic fix didn't work because it wasn't full screen. Or like widescreen, I mean. So wait with installing that? Yeah, but here's the thing, I need a basic Need for Speed for it to work, I think. Let's just see if this works. This is now regular. Oh, no, wait. I thought I copy-pasted this. Guess I didn't. Just wait until this is finished. And how about we just leave this alone and just mess with the no speed limit one. I don't think this met now. DX web setup. .exe. Oh, now I can. Maybe this is what I needed? Bing bar? What the hell? No. Fuck off. Yeah. Oh, okay. Throw your hands in the air right now, man. Yes. Okay. Right here. Scott starts. Yeah, Khaled, I see you. I'm expecting yes. This is looking already so much better. It's a bit loud. I agree. I will fix that immediately. Okay, this is already so much better. So I guess just the okay. Now that I have that, just now that we have an alias and stuff, we can now go back to NFS Pro Street, have our settings, copy that back. Now we should be able to start this back up, and oh, it doesn't go to. Okay, so we need to manually adjust the. Okay. It is in 16:9 though. That's for sure. It is in 16:9. It's just not in the great resolution. But let's. VSync is enabled though. Should only be able. Why can't I pick 1440p? What the hell is this? Okay, that's weird. Oh. Get tight when you're worth some millions. That's why I start the chinchilla hurt their feelings. You can find your crack it all tight. Out of Vegas front row to all the fights. If I were born come, then they proudly squeal. Cause at the rappers, they're like dirt for real. If you cross the line, damn right, I'm gonna hurt you. These even made gang signs commercial. Okay. Even Lil Bow Wow. Can I save? You know, these old games, you know, they just require a bit of work in order to work. Do I have to do this? Oh my god, that's terrible. Why is it? Oh, because I didn't install the generic fix. Maybe that's needed. This is why we installed the generic fix. Otherwise, it is this. 30 FPS lock. Oh, that's terrible. Okay. But so weird. Why is the menu at 144p? Okay, let's put this back in. Now we should be able. Okay, so it's now at 1080p. It's not broken. Well, it is broken, but I can fix this. I now should be able, first of all, obviously, to and graphics. There we go. There's a lovely 1440p. Now it goes all the way up. Yes, that's what I love to see. You can immediately see that the HUD is absolutely terrible. No, Root. I'm fixing this. Can we, if I say create a race day, it should save. Now it did. Now it's saved. Oh, that's not what I needed. I would be so pissed, Magnus, if that if it was all for nothing. Okay, that's all good now. It's looking beautimous again. What I'm now going to do, leave this alone for now. And then I'm going to, that wasn't needed by the way, to no speed limit. Is that how I want it to be? Copy all this to this. And then I'm going to include the no speed limit and the HUD mod. Then we can start back from where we were. I have no idea what time it is because my monitor resolution is messed up. Oh, it's 10 o'clock. Okay. Seconds. Okay. We can already grab. Let's have a look. Pro Street modding. Let's first do VLT. Have it ready. Go launch this. I'm gonna reopen it just in case. There we go. Save. So the speed limit has now been implemented. Now we're going to binary. User modes. Install. Games. Classic games. Need for speed. Pro Street, no speed limits. Boom. It has been successfully saved files and run the game for me, please. Okay. So the HUD mod completely messes everything up. That's unfortunate. That's really unfortunate. But what's even more unfortunate is that there is no disable thingy. Okay, well, that means at least we go away. So we now do is remove all this. And copy paste this back in again. And then just leave the HUD mod for now. I'm gonna install, try to get that to work off stream. Just install the no speed limit for now. And then start all over. Well, not start, maybe we still have the 240SX save. Excuse me. Maybe it's busted, or maybe I need to play a little bit. Well, that's basically what I'm doing now, Root. I can't wait for the weekend. It's weird that that HUD mod just did not work, because last time I installed it, it worked perfectly, as you saw. But I'm not going to mess with that for now. I'm just going to do that off stream. Perhaps tomorrow, I don't know. Or maybe I can make take a screenshot and ask some guys around. Okay, that's installed. Let's get ourselves. Where are you? Even though it's not really needed now, because it's not like we're actually achieving set top speed. But I'm gonna not mess with that anymore for this stream. I'm just going to continue like normal. This time with a worse HUD. I mean, maybe on stream you're not going to notice it, but... anything else that I need to fix? No, everything has been enabled. Okay, let's continue where we left off and let's hope this has fixed it.
Hey, we all got a cheer for Ryan Cooper out there today too. Especially
you do notice the text being terrible right now, but let's ignore that for now. I will be already glad if everything is alright right now. I mean, and I would say any game that is not in the HD universe, so like from Pro Street downwards, you need a... I mean, I never like had an HUD improved mod beforehand. But when I played Tomatoes mod for the first time, I realized I need an HUD mod as well. Or like fix. Because yeah, you can definitely... It's showing its age, basically, the text. Is the game running a bit smoother on stream? Because I think I need to disable external VSync. But I'm gonna do that after this race weekend. Yeah, I mean, if the game crashes again, I mean, then all of that was for nothing. Yep. I also don't know if this autosave has been enabled or this, I don't know. One more race. I'm gonna do the time attack. I'm still gonna keep this part one for the stream, because we've done a substantial amount. Oh, you can definitely see it's running a bit choppier right now. Even though we're running at 144 FPS. Oh, that did not. Isn't running as smooth as it used to. So I'm going to disable VSync after this race weekend. Or after this race, actually. A 108 Joe Tackett lap. Take. Air Control. You're recommending all of these games that I haven't heard of. Shift 2, no. It's one of those games that I just genuinely don't like playing, Shift 2. Same like Payback, same like Need for Speed 2. Those three games, those three Need for Speeds, and Nitro, and Rivals, are a couple of Need for Speeds that I will probably never ever, like, do a playthrough of again, because I just don't like those Need for Speeds. Skip cutscene! We dominated. 15,000, sure, whatever. Ooh, we unlocked GFX. Alright, so that's done. I'm now going to disable external VSync. And of course, save, because I don't know if autosave is enabled. So that's from here, off, or like this one. Same with, I think they're the same. The same, yeah, okay, they're using this exact same stuff. Okay, so now that is disabled, now I'm gonna start Pro Street again. Why did it not save the resolution? Not like, okay, this is all good, this is all good, this is all good. Is it like, where are you? Oh, it's because this is okay. Yeah, then it makes sense. this one needs to be on 1, otherwise it just doesn't save your settings. Now it again is going to show the 1080p resolution. Actually, it's kind of insane the difference between 1080p and 1440p. Because we're now at 1080p, the resolution I've been gaming on for so long. And then now going to 1440p. Boom. Everything else is all good. I'm going to disable VSync and enable VSync just to make sure. Yes. Continue. Now it's running hella smooth again for me. Let's go reacting sessions and continue where we left off. This is one of those race weekends I just don't like, because I don't like the GTO for grip, I don't like the GTO for drift, so that's mainly why. It's a shame that YouTube doesn't go past 60 FPS. I wish you could see this in the 144 FPS. So much smoother than your 60 FPS. Yeah. No. Here's the thing. The GTO for drift isn't that bad. It's actually in the top 15. But I just don't like it. Like, I want to bring for drifting stage 4 the top 15 cars for stage 4 testing, and the GTO is in the top 15. So yeah. That's too late. Fuck. I should know better. I've raced on this track, or like driven on this track, so many times. It is weird, you know, racing on a track where I've been testing cars on for so many times now. The worst car in Most Wanted is the Vauxhall Monaro, and actually the Pontiac GTO. If you can beat the game with that, you can beat it with anything. I do feel a slight difference in how the game runs in comparison how it used to run before we reinstalled it. Could be me, but that's one of those things that I try to really pay attention on. That's a bit wide, that's a bit ambitious. Oh, because I'm not a game designer nor a game developer. I don't have the skills to do so. mean on my screen that I am currently reviewing the stream itself. It looks very choppy. I'm gonna have a quick look. With the music obviously disabled. Just know how to check and stuff. Or maybe it's just in my screen. Yeah, because this looks actually quite good. Looks worse on OBS. Okay. Then it's just a screen. It's a crappy old screen anyway, so that's probably why. Drifty with the GTO because that's a better car in this race day. That was not a computer, it's the, well, I don't need a new screen, but it just looks terrible frame rate wise on my external monitor. True, true. Decent. Computer wise, oh, no. First, thank you very much. PC wise has been doing me, you know, quite decent lately. No funny businesses in the last, I would say, half year or so. So, that's all, that's indeed good. Keep it on the black stuff. Hey, Dark. And yeah, Imperator. Yeah, Imperator. I mean, the graphics haven't been modified. It's just that we're running on a proper widescreen resolution. Even the HUD isn't modified, which is something I do want to do for the next stream again, if I can get it to work. Yeah, that just means that Pro Street just, oh yeah, we're not, oh we are. Ooh, 7,000, wow, look at that. So far so good, because reinstalling it did fix it for now. The GTO has more power in drift and that's why I like it. I feel like I can throw it more into angles. I feel like while drifting it holds its angles more better. Perhaps just like the Netgear, it just needed a reinstall. I don't know. For stage 3 at least, the classic Dodge Challenger is the best drag car. I don't know about stage 4. Could be the Zonda, could be the Challenger, could be the Supra, who knows. feel like the engine sound is a bit low. I don't know if it's just me, but I'm gonna put it to 65. Should have gone to the inside there. Lovely. He overshot it a bit. That's a bit ambitious. It's like Lewis Hamilton in Baku in 21. Of course I do. Or do you mean the movie cars? Because to that I also answered this. Except for Cars 2, I didn't like that. But I did like Cars 1 and 3. And that is a finish. Thank you very much. Who started to run out of questions? Random one. 10k, okay. Take the GTO because I think it's more expensive. I think that, yes, okay, so now. Okay, we do have quite some money. So let's repair this for now with cash. Get ourselves two additional 240SXs. Why are DLC cars free again for me? You are joking. What, but Sam, BP1 is not valid? What the hell? Okay, well, this is not an issue for now. Because we need the 240SX anyway, but I do need to fix this, of course, eventually. But then that also means... just... yeah, look at this, we just don't have version 1.1 installed. Hang on. I am going to look into this if we can quickly fix this, because I do think that was here as well. Mods and fixes. Version 1.1. Was it like game downloads? It's a 1.1 version multi. Okay. Oh, look, they have a new ISO. They've made a fire now. Oh, bounce blocked. I think this is still the same one that I've been using. Yeah, this is the one that I've been using. Probably a save game issue. That's what I think. But you know, for this playthrough, it isn't an issue. So I'm just going to leave it alone for now. But what I am curious about... This is my testing... No, this is also still 57. Okay. I'll fix that later. Oh yeah, we were going to get ourselves multiple 240 SXs. One for speed. And one for drifty-wifty. Oh, we have five now. Okay. Hang on. We have two for speed. Okay, so let's sell this one. I thought, yeah, I was toying with the idea for red for a 240 SX. Oh, wait, we don't have the spare. Obviously, we need that. Where are you? Special vinyls. Just the documents. Don't tell me I just fucking removed it. Okay. Okay, Pro Street Special Vinyls Unlocker. Let's download you. Let's put you in the speed limit because you literally can go in there. Just an ASI, that's all it needs. Yeah, might finish just setting up the 240 SXs. And I can then call a stream. 1995 Monopoly, why? This is speed, and I was toying with the idea for like a dark blue-ish version for this. Maybe matte, how about we do a matte one? Okay, not matte. Or how about I was toying with the idea. Yeah, that's just too much like the regular one. What, like a fluorescent or like this is not bad. I like this. Maybe a bit more cyan-y. This is not too bad looking. I think I'm gonna go with this for our speed builds. And honestly, this... Do I have this for the grip? I don't know if even have this for the grip version. Can't remember which one it is. It is this one. Then, let's not do the engine for now. Stage 2 for this. Stage 2 for that. Stage 1 engine. And stage 2 NOS. That's all I'm gonna do for now. And later we're gonna see how what we need for that. Blueprint, it has 171 brake horsepower, which is not a lot. I think this does have, yes it does have that. We need more power, so I'm gonna add a forced induction for you. Suspension for you also. And let's just, no, you know what? This is already decent. We also need to set up a drift car. Yeah, we had some technical difficulties to say the least, but yeah, it's going decently. Drag. I don't want to do too much about the drag version. Maybe stage 2 NOS? I know, let's just do the drifty wifty version. Visuals, finals. 13. Oh, nice. Paints. I'm gonna do red first, see how that looks. Metallic red. I mean, that does match the front light. Because this is a vinyl, this is just regular color. But I do want a bit darker though. That's too dark. Or how about just gloss? How about candy? Ooh, hello. It's not bad looking. I think I'm gonna do this for drift. This looks pretty good. Maybe just one lighter to match the front lights. I'm gonna do this. This looks pretty good. Then, body kit. You. And wheels, all wheels. We don't need to like upgrade the drift car too much, because all it really needs for me is like forced induction. We do need tires, but I'm going to reduce that. And suspension level 2. No, wait, suspension level, I think, yeah, level 2, but we're gonna reduce that to stock 2, and then just one or so NOS bottle. So let's do, no, wait, it needs a different tune. So like 1, 2, 3, and all this except for, I think this needs to be left alone. Boom, 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 boom. Then you just reduced the suspension to stock, because then you gain your money back and your tires to stock. So you gain your money back as well. But it has been tuned. Because if we go to stage, we can also do stage 3 tire, basically. Massive money, massive hack this. As you can see, it is still tuned. So you can just buy whatever you need. And just leave the rest as is. because suspension, stock, tires, stock. That's it. I don't think we ever need to touch the drift car again. So now we have all four cars. We're just going to need a wheelie car later on, but I'm going to make this a bit more blue. And I'm going to make that candy as well. Looks good, candy color. What time is it? I don't see what time it is. It's nearly 11. I think what I'm gonna do, well, first of all, I think we can safely say that reinstalling the game has fixed the crashing issue. So what I'm gonna do is enable autosave for now. Cause where are we now, right now? We just did the reacting session. So I'm gonna see if I can get version 1.1 working again. It's not needed for this playthrough, but it is obviously needed for stage 4 testing. I'm going to see if I can get the HUD mod working again. And we'll see when the next stream is. So I'm going to leave it here for now. And basically see when the next stream is. So, yeah, I think I can call it a semi-successful first playthrough stream. Semi-successful. At least from stream-wise, it went all right. You know, we're getting, we're just getting there. Yeah, Magnus, Flame, Roots, all you guys, thank you so much for watching. Like, subscribe, all that stuff. The next stream is, I don't know when, I will announce it on Discord and I will do a premiere shortly before. So, yeah, see you guys later. With a string on you.